Thakur. Listen here. Squares, square numbers. 1 square is 1. 2 square is 4. 3 square is 9. 4 square is 16. 5 square is 25. 6 square is 36. Square of 7 is 49. 8 square 64. 9 square 81. 10 square 100. Almost all the students, you know the square numbers, that is 1 to 10, isn't it? When you are squaring 1 to 10, you will get the answer. Every student, almost all the students, you know this. 11 square, 12 square up to 20, there is an easy way to remember, or there is an easy way to write. Mentally, you can calculate it. 11 into 11. Just you take this unit place alone. Here, what is the number in unit place? 1. Here, what is the number in unit place? 1. Since you are squaring, same number only you will get in the unit place. And also in tens place, isn't it? So, first you multiply these two numbers, what it is given in unit place. So, 1 into 1. Next, here you add the same numbers here, what it is given in the unit places. So, 1 plus 1. Then, you multiply these two numbers, what it is in tens place. 1, 1 is 1. That is 1, 2, 1. Next, 12 square. That is 12 into 12, isn't it? That means 2, 2 are. Next one is 2 plus 2. 1, 1 is 1. That is 1, 2 plus 2, 4. 2, 2 are 4. 144. 13 into 13. Just we will try to write the answer directly. 3, 3. 3, 3 are 9. 3 into 3, it is 9. Next, same numbers. 3 plus 3 is 6. Then 1 into 1 is 1. Next, 14 into 14. Here, just you should be careful. 4 fours are 16. For out of that 16, you have to write 6 alone here. You write this 1 in the center. Then 4 plus 4. Here, what you are going to write? 4 plus 4. Understand? Here, 1, 1 is 1. But you see, the 6 is as it is. 4 plus 4 is what? 8. 8 plus 1 is 9. Next what? 1. 196. Next, 15 into 15. There is a shortcut method for numbers which are ending in 5. In Vedic maths, I taught the method, isn't it? That is, 5 means what the last 2 digits? 25. Then, what is the successor of 1? 2. You got to multiply these two. 1, 2 is 2. Then, 2, 5. 25. 225. Next, 16 into 16. Which number you got to take? 6, 6. What you should do? You have to multiply these two numbers. 6, 6 are 36. Remainder 3. Then 6 plus 6 is 12. 12 plus 3 is 15. Remainder 1. 1, 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So what is the answer? 256. Next, 17 into 17. 17 square. 17 square, you are while you are expand, when you are writing the expansion, 17 into 17. That is 7 sevens are 49. Remainder 4. Remainder 4. Mentally you should do it. Remainder 4. 7 plus 7 is 14. 14 plus 4 is 18. Remainder 1. 1 into 1, 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. So 289. Then 18 into 18. 8 eights are 64. Remainder 6. Keep it in mind. 8 plus 8 is 16. 16 plus 6 is 22. Remainder 2. 1, 1 is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 324. Then 19 into 19. 9 nines are 81. Remainder 8. 9 plus 9 is 18. 18 plus 8 is 26. Remainder 2. 1, 1 is 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. 361. 20 you know, isn't it? 20 into 20 means what? There are 2 zeros. Then 2 twos are 4. 400. This is one way of writing the square numbers from 11 to 20. Otherwise, there is another way to write this. Just you listen to me. 14 square, 15 square, 16 square, 17 square, 18 square, 19 square, 20 square. For this, first you should observe these squaring numbers. You see, 1 and 9. What is the unit place ending with 1? Then 2 and 8. First one is what? 1 comma 9. This is one pair. Next one is 2 comma 8. This is ending with 4. Unit place is 4. Next 3 and 7. 3 and 7 is another pair. Ending with 9. Ending with 9. Unit place is 9. Next one is 4 and 6. Next pair is 4 and 6. Ending with 6. Ending with 6. How can you pair this? 1 plus 9 is what? 10. 2 and 8 is 10. 3 plus 7 is 10. 4 plus 6 is 10. So 1, 9, 2, 8, 3, 7, 4, 6. Like rhyme, you can say these pairs. So 1 and 9 means the numbers ending with 1 and 9, the unit digit will be 1. The numbers ending with 2 and 8, the unit digit will be 4. The numbers ending with 3 and 7, the unit digit will be 9. The numbers ending with 4 and 6, the unit digit will be 6. While you are squaring. Then 5 you know. All these numbers. While you are squaring 5, the numbers, the unit place will be 5. So if you know this very well, you can write. Understand? So what is it? 121. 1, because up to 14, very well you can write. 144. 1 plus 1. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 twos are 4. 2 plus 2 is 4. Similarly, 3 threes are 9. 3 plus 3 is 6. 169. Next one is what? 169. Just you write, change and write. 69, 96. 69, 96. 15 already we know, isn't it? Last 2 digits is 25. Then 1, 2 is 2, 225. So these 5, within a fraction of second, you will be able to write. Here also, you will be able to write. But you see, I told you the conditions here, no? 6 means the unit digit will be 6. What is the previous number of 6? 5. You write that 5. Then what is it? 2. 256. Because this is after 5. So there won't be 1. So 256. Then 7 means what? It will end with 9. What is the predecessor? Previous number for 9? 8. Then automatically you will write 2. Then 18. 8. 8 means what? 2. 8 means 4. Sorry. 8 means 4. What is the predecessor? Previous number of 4. 3. But you don't write the 3 here. Because here there will be a change. So this 3 should be written in 100th place. Understand? Then what is the previous number for 3? 2. Understand? So 324. Then 9. 9 means what? The unit digit will be 1. Then 3. Automatically here also 3 only. While adding 6, you will get this 9. 3 plus 6 is 9. Since you are getting 3, then automatically you will write 3 here. Then 3 plus 6 is 9. So 361. Here 400. Is it okay? Here you see the instructions. The square numbers, the ending digits will be, you observe this, 0, 1, 4, 5, 6 or 9. What are the numbers are not there? You see here, there is a gap. That is 2 and 3. Here you see, between 6 and 9, 7 and 8. So, square numbers, none of these end with 2, 3, 7, 8. 2, 3, 7, 8. So, if you are unable to remember this, just you say this word for 2, 3, BC. Because this is the second letter and this is the third letter. Then, GH. BC, GH. What is it? BC, GH. To remember this, just you can write. Otherwise, this is the successor only. Here is a gap. In the beginning, there is a gap. Then this ending, that's all. You don't consider this 0. Because 0 we know, isn't it? Automatically 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So we know. So, first beginning, 1 is there. Then 2 and 3 is not there. The last number is what? 9. So, previous to that, 8. Then 7. 7 and 8. Is it okay? Then let us do this, try this. Can we say whether the following numbers are perfect squares? How do we know? We know very well, isn't it? I told you, no? That is, let me choose the 2. It is not a perfect square ending with 2. 3. It is not a perfect square. 2, 3. 7. It is not a perfect square. 8. It is not a perfect square. B, C, G, H. Is it okay? Then 9, 1. So it may be a square. It may be a perfect square. But it is not so. I worked out it for you. It is not a perfect square. Since you can say that it is ending with 9, it may be a square number. But I worked out it and I saw it is not a perfect square. Next one is 2061. It is ending with 1 because we said that square numbers are ending with 0, 1, 4, 5, 6, 9. So, with this condition, just we can say that it may be a perfect square. I worked out for you. But it is not a perfect square. Understand? So, none of the number is a perfect square. How do we know means? Just you can say that the numbers ending with 2, 3, 7, 8 are not perfect square. But 1 and 9, it may be a square number. But you work out and see, it is not a perfect square here. Is it okay?